People, I like to make fun of my country a lot, the Netherlands. But I'm gonna be honest. From time to time, my country can be beautiful. One of those times is spring. I love to show you around in my country, show you some of its landscapes, show you some of its climate and the species that we find here. Unfortunately though, we had the coldest spring in 35 years time, older than I am. So this delayed my outdoor filming a lot. Finally today we have one of the rare days of sunlight. And once again we can proceed filming. Let's go! Ladies and gentlemen, finally it's spring. The river behind me is a river called the Waal, and this is a commercially very important river in the Netherlands. As you can see, there's many container ships coming and going. There's millions of dollars of goods being transported here every hour. That's a conservative estimation. But I'm not here to talk economics, I'm an online biologist. And today I am going to follow the riverbank. Along the riverbank there's mainly just grasslands and a few forests, which will be an interesting place to do some field ecology. So what am I going to concretely show you today? I don't know. Today we are going to go with the flow. Usually I plan these videos out, I think, this is a species I want to show you today. And then I go look for this species. But today is different, we are just going to go with the flow. And whatever we find, I will try to film it for you and talk about it. Sound good? Let's go! Let me ask you guys a question. Do you guys like flowers? See, I am not much of a botanist myself. I am not very knowledgeable about plants. But I do recognize most of the common species. But this one here is a pretty funny one that I want to talk about. Why? Because the flowers are very pretty. One of the things about this flower here that I like is its name. I think the name is beautiful. It is the Garden Star of Bethlehem. I am not a religious person. Despite that, I think that's a very pretty name, the Garden Star of Bethlehem. Sounds very mythical, doesn't it? I don't know if you guys are into religion. I don't know much about it, but I do know the Star of Bethlehem was like this star that appeared in the sky. And according to folklore, fragments of this star were broken off. And they resulted into these flowers. That's a funny bit of folklore. What's also interesting is that it is family of the asparagus. It belongs to the asparagus family of plants. That's not something you would expect, but yeah, it's pretty interesting. Scientific name, Ornithogalum umbellatum. This plant is native throughout most of the southern and central Europe and northwestern Africa. Despite the known toxicities, the plant has been described as edible for 2000 years. They can thrive in meadows and humid places, and interestingly, they can form bulbs that transport themselves by drifting in water, but they can also form seeds. It prefers damp habitats, being found along rivers, streams, and lower wet areas of pastures. So I have a question to my viewers. Are any Christians or Jewish people watching this? And do you know more about the Star of Bethlehem? Because let me tell you about me. I was raised without religion by my parents. When I was young, I haven't been taught anything religious at school. So when you ask me about the Bible and the story, I'm surprisingly completely ignorant. Like, not once in my life have I read the Bible or attempted to read any religious book. And obviously I'm not religious myself. Some people find it weird when I tell them that, like, oh, how can you not know the story of the Bible? It's just, I wasn't brought up with it, and I never took the time to immerse myself in it. Should I take the time to do that? I don't know. I feel like even without religion, I'm a very happy and content person. That being said, maybe I am very ignorant on a significant part of, well, culturally human history. Because let's be honest, the story of the Bible is like 2,000 years old, right? And it has a lot of impact on our society today, even though religion is not that popular anymore. I'm basically completely ignorant atheist. Like, honestly, I can't even tell you anything about it. But the good news is I can tell you a lot about nature, which is why my channel is about. Just throwing that out there for you guys. Because maybe somebody wants to enlighten me what all of this means, because I have no idea. I'm clueless, totally clueless. But yeah, the Garden Star of Bethlehem, everybody. Mythical name, mythical name. Wow, ladies and gentlemen, immediately I have found something interesting. A whole bunch of white flowers. And they are swarming with insects, in particular butterflies. This plant is hawthorn, scientific name Crataegus. It has many flowers in spring. And it seems to be attracting a lot of insects that are interesting to this channel. So let's have a closer look, shall we? If you guys watch a lot of my content, this butterfly, you're going to see a lot of footage of it. The Atalanta. I can see at least three of them in the bushes right now. This one appears to have at least a somewhat damaged hind wing. Don't know if you guys can see it. Oh, there it goes. And here we have a Vanessa Atalanta. Whoop, there it goes. This hawthorn bush behind me is absolutely swarming with butterflies. So I'm going to take my net and capture as many of them as I can. This is a bit a terrible net. Like, the handle has broken, I only have this to hold in my hand. But it should work. Don't worry, I'm going to release all the butterflies after the video, okay? Just to see the species diversity. Disclaimer, if you catch butterflies for your YouTube channel, make sure they are not protected species. I never catch species that are protected by the law, okay? Very important, think of the ethics. I will release them afterwards, we will just respectfully capture and film them. Ha, huh, gotcha. Specimen number one, species Vanessa Atalanta. I have this cute little cage here, I can release it, as you can see, so we can observe it for a short time. Aha! I spy a butterfly and I wonder if I can catch it in the hawthorn. Yeah! Gotcha! Aha! There we go. What a surprise! It's a Vanessa Atalanta! Specimen number two, Vanessa Atalanta again. Seems to be an older one, it has more damage. Specimen number three, Vanessa Atalanta, what a surprise. What's cool about the wings of a butterfly is that their wings can tell us a story. What's funny is that if we look at the colors of this butterfly, the colors are very pristine. So that makes me conclude this is a very fresh butterfly. It must be, it didn't have that many flight hours. But there is like this chip here missing in his wing. And this chip, this is bird damage. When birds attack butterflies, which happens constantly by the way, their beak will like, it'll peck a small hole in their wing. And usually it rips out here like this, it rips out pieces of their wing in this pattern. So this is actually a very freshly, a fresh butterfly in a good condition. It is young, but it has suffered a bird attack. And this type of damage is very different from old age. When butterflies are old age, their colors tend to fade away. They become less bright. And there's like small chips missing in the wing. But if you see like this big chip missing like this, especially in a fresh specimen, it means it was attacked by a wild animal, in particular a bird. Interesting, huh? Three specimens so far in just a few minutes time, and they are all the Vanessa Atalanta. Seems that's the only butterfly that likes hawthorn as much. That's an interesting observation. There are many more species of butterflies around us, but the only ones visiting the hawthorn are this species. So that's actually an interesting discovery. This video is not planned out. I literally just go with the flow. If life gives you lemons, make lemonade! Huh. Shit, I missed it. Specimen number 4, what a surprise. Vanessa Atalanta. This specimen seems to be of middle age. His blood red colors have more or less faded to a lighter orange. Its pigments have degraded a little bit. Still, it's not terribly old. It looks in good condition. There's little damage. Like I said, the wings of a butterfly, they tell a story. Specimen number 6. Can you guys see it? Bird attack damage. I hope that after this video you guys have learned how to research and how to identify bird attack damage. If there's like just one chip missing, it was most likely a bird using their beak to peck at it. Pretty interesting. Specimen number 5, Vanessa Atalanta. Number 7. Vanessa Atalanta, how surprising. Completely perfect, undamaged specimen. So that's quite cool. See, it's completely perfect. Probably very fresh butterfly. Alright people, so in one swipe of my net I just caught two butterflies that are chasing each other, and no surprise, they are Vanessa Atalanta. Caught another one. Guess what? Vanessa Atalanta! Ladies and gentlemen, that was a very enlightening experience. When I saw the bush full of butterflies, I was happy. I was like, yay, so many species of butterflies. Turns out the hawthorn is being swarmed by just by one species, the Red Admiral, or Vanessa Atalanta. And in just a few minutes time I was able to catch like 10 of them. Wow! That's an interesting observation. I guess other species of butterflies don't like this flower. And now I'm going to release them. Proof. These things are very easy to breed, but I already did it last year. There's a cool video about it on my channel. Check that out. There you go. Bye bye guys. Bye bye. Oh, you are trying to sit here, huh? Come on, guy, fly away, or not. Stay with me if you want to. I'm your friend. Oh, there you go. Come on, guys, be free. Be free. There you go. There you go. Let's talk about the ethics of harassing butterflies for views. I think it's perfectly acceptable. I am not harming these animals in any way or shape. I am associated with butterfly conservation. I've even done research with butterflies. I'm a biologist who hopes to promote their conservation in the wild. Me catching them will give them maybe a little bit of stress, but I think that stress is worth it if it means I can make an educational video talking about these insects, right? There's a lot of people who sometimes cry, why you're hurting the butterflies? These are the delusional kind of animal rights activists who are really starting arguments in the wrong places. My channel has always been in favor of conservation and ethical breeding and studying of butterflies and moths, my favorite animals. I'm here to educate you about them. But yes, I think, oh, there's still one in the cage. Huh, forgot about you, my friend. I personally believe that society benefits from stuff like this. Sometimes you have to watch nature up close in order to understand it, in order to get a good idea of what nature is like. Make sure when you catch something that is not protected by law, do not catch protected species. It's illegal to disturb, harass, or sell them. But I make sure this is not protected stuff. Let's go. Some of you watching this video right now must be like, wow, hawthorn must be an amazing plant for butterflies and insects. You're not wrong, but this plant is one of the first plants to flower like this in spring. And that's why so many butterflies love it. But later in the season, when it gets warmer, you hardly see any butterflies on it. That's because other plants start flowering, which have their preference and they prefer to visit those flowers instead. It's kind of like you go out drinking with some of your mates, you are drunk, you're really hungry, and all the restaurants in your area are closed. The only one that is open is some kind of shitty, greasy hamburger restaurant. So you and your mates have to go there every day after you went clubbing or you went to the pub. And people will say, oh, these guys must really love greasy hamburgers. Well, not exactly. It's just because you didn't have any other options, you know? You ever had that feeling when you were hungry and the only thing that was open was some shitty Subway restaurant? Or you were really craving something else? You were craving like curry, whatever. Just making up some examples. This is kind of the equivalent. In spring, there's not that many flowers yet because everything is still blooming and growing and budding. So the early flowers are kind of like the first food providers for the butterflies. And that's the hawthorn. If we come back in about a month, I doubt we'll see this many. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm very excited. I just saw one of the biggest butterflies in my country. And the only species of swallowtail you can find in the Netherlands. I really hope I can film it. It's flying very fast and it's very hard to see. But if you watch closely, you'll see this big yellow butterfly. And this is the king of butterflies in my country. The old world swallowtail, Papilio machaon. Can you guys see it? It likes to fly around here. It circles around the road before choosing a place to settle finally. It's kind of an annoying habit because you never know what it's going to do. Oh my God, people, there it was. Finally, here it is, the close-up I wanted. I guess it got tired. I'm not going to try and get any closer because it's very easy to scare away and I really want this close-up. This is the only species of swallowtail in my country, the only one. Papilio machaon, the old world swallowtail. In my country they are commonly seen flying along the river's edge. I don't know why. It's probably because their host plants grow along the rivers as well. And it's also probably just an easy route to migrate around. These populations can be very stationary and territorial, but they can also go migratory mode and just migrate for very long distances across the country and then settle somewhere else where their host plants are present. What a beautiful species. It is personally my favorite. I'm going to see if I can get any closer, probably not. Capturing and filming this species is a challenge. Can you see it, how fast it's flying? This species is a bit, it is uncommon in my country. I only see a few of them every year. So it's a bit of a rare moment. The sand along the riverbank is interesting because here lives a certain predator. Only here around the river shore, the river's edge. It's a very fast moving one that's difficult to film, so I'm gonna have to resort to my trusty net, see if I can catch one of these predators. Ow, 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 it's biting me. Ah, look at those jaws. Ah. What a predator! This aggressive little thing is a Cincidela sand beetle. As you can see, it has a massive pair of jaws. It is very much a predator in all regards. They are very common here among riverbanks in the sand. They can run very fast. And they are predators of things like ants, but also smaller spiders, maybe even moths, anything they can catch here on the sands. Very interesting little beetles. Very common, so I'm gonna let it go. Yep, there it goes. Here goes one. Can you guys see it? These things move like they're on drugs, to be honest. It's very hard to film, whoa. Look at that. This is a predatory beetle and these predatory beetles are common along the riverbanks here. Whoop, there it goes. From a far distance, the way these things move and walk and run kind of reminds me of flies, see? But they are beetles. Whoop, and when they detect movement, they just lash out. Flowers. Flowers as far as the eye can see. Now this is a landscape I love, ladies and gentlemen. I think I've come across the Dutch equivalent of the supermoon. Mother Nature, I hope you don't mind if I pick one of your flowers. Now I believe that this plant, I am not a very good botanist, so please correct me if I'm wrong. But I believe this is cow parsley. Antricus sylvestris. And do you guys remember when a few moments ago I showed you footage of a wild old world swallowtail butterfly? Papilio machon is the only species of swallowtail in my country, in fact. This stuff is one of their host plants. The old world swallowtail can, in fact, lay eggs on these plants. And if you are very lucky, you can find caterpillars or eggs on it. However, this is very rare. Why is that? Because this is one of their potential host plants, but it's not their favorite. So, I don't understand why it's not their favorite, but these butterflies have their preferences. And the caterpillars have been observed on these flowers once in a while, the cow parsley plant. Despite that, I think it's uncommon to find swallowtail eggs or caterpillars on this. It can happen, but it's a bit rarish. Gust of wind. Actually, one of the favorite food plants of the old world swallowtail in my country is carrot. Yes, carrot, the same type of carrot that you find in the supermarket. Daucus carota is where I often find the caterpillars and eggs in my country. It doesn't seem to grow here very much, but maybe if you like the old world swallowtail, I can sometime show you a place where they actually breed a lot. But yeah, this is a beautiful field full of cow parsley. A beautiful plant, it's thriving here in spring. So if we're lucky, maybe we'll see another swallowtail. It is one of their host plants, so they could be attracted to this place, it makes sense. Wow. So many flowers, people. Guys, my channel has a super fan. His name is Rob. I cannot reveal too much information about Rob because I respect his privacy, of course. But he gave me this GoPro, a very expensive gift that I am very, very, very thankful for. And I will use it as much as possible if I have the opportunity. Because of course we like to see some good images. Now this is the perfect opportunity. So I'm going to use the GoPro and you guys can see from my perspective what's it like here to walk among the flowers. It's pretty cool. So I can attach the GoPro. I can attach this to this clip. See guys? It's an action camera. Let me see how I mounted it last time. Oh yeah, you can mount it like this. Here on the clip. Use a screw to attach it. There you go. I've been getting really generous support for my YouTube channel. I'm very thankful for this. My channel is basically entirely demonetized. So when I upload videos, I don't make shit from it. So stuff like this is very meaningful to me if I want to grow my channel. It's an extraordinary gift from a super fan. Rob, if you're watching this, I don't think there's any type of words that I can say that to repay you or make it up to you. In return, I really just hope to repay you with entertaining videos. Because that's what I do, I entertain. Let's turn it on, people. Here's the GoPro. It looks stable. It's mounted like this. So there we go. Let's have a nice walk through the flowers, huh? Shall we? Through the cow parsley. That's a bummer. The sun just stopped shining. Nonetheless, it shouldn't make this content any less good, guys. Here we go. The Netherlands Flower GoPro vlog in spring. Wow. It's beautiful. It's beautiful, isn't it? It's almost like there's snow on the landscape. Isn't it? Almost like it has snowed. So much beautiful white. Now in the distance we see the dike, which basically this whole place floods in winter, and this prevents the water from flooding the villages. But yeah, wow, it's pretty incredible, people. So much dense vegetation, so many flowers. Hope not too many influencers come take selfies in the super bloom. Sorry guys, this is my place alone. Bart Koppen's territory, my secret location. Wow, it smells pretty strong too. The smell is pretty hard to describe. It kind of smells like a vegetable. It's not super sweet. The flowers do have this both a sweet and a savory smell. Like, it's very hard to describe if you never smelled it before. But yeah. Plant Biology Lesson 101. Yes. This time I'm covering more plants on my channel than usual. But I know a thing about about plants. Not that much. I'm not an expert, but I know the basics, like I said before. And this plant here is a plant called woad. Isatis tinctoria. It has yellow flowers, and what is interesting is this plant is thought to originate from the steppes of Central Asia. Now, I don't live in Central Asia, so what the heck is this woad plant doing here? Turns out that since the Neolithic, that was quite some time ago, humans have brought this plant to Europe to cultivate it for the production of blue dye. Yes, that's right. If you wanted to color something blue, then you cultivated this plant. Now, how something with such yellow flowers is able to produce blue pigment is beyond me. But I'm not a specialist in pigments and flowers. I do know it is a relative of cabbage. It is from the Brassicaceae family. And it's pretty common here in sandy areas. Technically it's an introduced species, but it's been naturalized for a really, really long time. I'm gonna be honest, people. I like this riverbank. It's a peaceful place. Sometimes when I'm in a bad place in life, when I'm facing difficulties, when I make mistakes or have regrets, then I just come here and chill and just contemplate about life. That probably sounds a little bit pathetic. But you know what? Each to their own. Each to their own. Don't worry about me though. I'm making it sound like I'm super depressed and have many problems behind the scenes. That's not exactly true. I'm happy with life. I'm happy where I am. It's not like that I have big issues. But you know, even I have difficulties from time to time. Maybe I will open up about them on YouTube someday. Maybe I will not. Who knows? I probably will, otherwise I wouldn't tease you like this, because it's going to make people curious, even if it's private. People are still going to be watching and wondering what these mysterious issues are. I kind of feel like I'm considering talking about it sometime on a video. Not sure if I'm going to be ready about that in a short time, but maybe like in a few months, let's say half a year or something, who knows. Maybe I'll find the right words. It is a very nice place, it's quiet, see? I like being alone from time to time. I definitely don't describe myself as a hermit. I interact with people very easily, I make friends very easily. Through this channel alone I made many friends. Sometimes I literally meet with strangers to make videos with them. So I'm definitely not a recluse, I'm not a hermit. I'm very often very extroverted. But I need my time to recharge after I have interactions with people. It's also good to be alone sometimes. Thank you. Let me talk to you guys about life in the Netherlands. It's not that bad. We are one of the richest countries in the world. We have a lot of social security. We don't have things like famine, extreme poverty. I'm not saying that the Netherlands is a paradise and we don't have poor people. We do. But I think that if you look at how people live in each country in the world, we should definitely be like in the top 10 of the countries where people are taken the most care of. That being said, I often feel out of place in this country. That's because what I really love is, I don't know, I just have a passion for wilderness. And the thing is, we don't really have a thing such as wilderness in the Netherlands. 52% of the land surface area of my country is farmland and pastures and agriculture. 52%! Like literally half the surface of the Netherlands is for farmers, is ruined by farmers, I dare say. Because wilderness has not much place in the Netherlands. A lot of it is managed farmland, managed forest, managed ecosystems. And I do crave wilderness from time to time. I don't want to make fun of our country and say our nature is inferior to other countries. I think each place on this planet has its own unique little ecosystem with its own unique little species. We saw beautiful flowers today, we saw beautiful butterflies. I'm blessed to have all that around me, am I not? I'm blessed. But I do often dream about really being in the middle of nowhere, you know. There are so many places in this world I haven't seen. Distant countries, foreign lands. And let's be honest, that's where most of the butterflies and moths are. I think a country like Brazil has like 2,000 species of butterflies or more. 2,000! We have like 54 species in comparison. That's quite something. Again, not trying to make fun of this and saying this is not worthy. This is inferior. I don't think so, but I enjoy it from time to time. It's hard to express this feeling, you know. It's just like, I know there is more out there and I haven't seen it. Look at all the ships. Pretty industrial river this is, the Waal. Ships just come and go constantly. The sun is pretty low in the sky, people. That means there will soon be the sunset and it means I will go home. Because it's gonna get dark. Alright people, this is the end of the video. I hope you enjoyed it. Can I ask you something? Can you imagine me making videos like this? Can you imagine me making videos like this in another country? That's what I would love to do. I would love to go to the rainforest, like French Guiana, Brazil, or maybe even part of the United States, Florida. How about Papua, where you have the biggest butterflies in the world? That is a dream of mine to do for YouTube. But I can't do it alone, because my YouTube channel is demonetized. When I upload a video like the video you watched today, I don't make a single dollar from it. Now, I am not entitled to your money. And you not giving me anything does not make you less of a viewer or subscriber. I value everybody who watches my channel. Everybody. But I am trying to raise funds. I am trying to crowdfund my channel. If you like my content, please consider subscribing to my Patreon. $1 a month already helps a lot, because it adds up if many people do it. And with that money, I buy stuff like bus tickets, I compensate for my free time. Another thing I would like to invest in is a new butterfly net, because this is just horrible. The handle broke. And hey, how can I make nice butterfly videos if I don't have a good butterfly net? I probably have to get a new one pretty soon. Imagine if there's a rare butterfly and I fail to catch it because I have this crappy old thing. I also want to thank Rob. Rob is the anonymous top level sponsor of my channel. He gave me this GoPro, but he also gave me a lot of other benefits. And I like to give him a shout out, but it doesn't feel like enough. Like, what can I do to repay somebody like that? Like, it's really, I'm really happy with the level of support I get from the people who follow this channel. I'm very blessed. I'm lucky. Don't you ever think I'm ungrateful, people. I am really not. I'm really, really, really happy. Despite that, I'm also ambitious, so I'm always trying to grow it as big as I can. Because then we can do really, really crazy things. Like, I don't know. Hey, it's getting cloudy, it's getting cold, and I'm getting hungry. My fat ass needs a little bit of nutrition. See you guys later. Have any tips? Any species you want me to film? Any parts in the Netherlands? Write it in the comments. Ta-da!